Thank you, savvy ladies. Thank you, people on this phone call. I knew before I started to prep that networking was important. What I've learned is it's much more important than I had realized. And I found out that there are tips and techniques and tricks to help us make the absolute most out of the time and money and energy that we spend in networking. I have to say hats off to savvy ladies. They listened to what people were telling them, which was, we would like information on networking, how to go about it, how to enjoy it, how to follow up. So therefore they asked me if I could focus specifically on networking. And networking is what I comes under. I have two types of communicating. I would call them presenting and presencing. The presenting is perhaps more formal, more structured, maybe a keynote speech, TEDx talk, podium speech. The presencing is every bit as important, and that would be the leading a meeting, talking to somebody at a networking dinner, running into someone on the street. All of those less structured events are every bit as critical in how we communicate, how confident we feel, how comfortable we are. Really, I have to say, it all heads up to confidence. So today I'm going to talk about how to create confidence. At the end of the webinar, I'll show you how you can get my 10 best tips for creating confidence. And also what you can do to appear confident when you're not necessarily. But confidence is definitely something that can be nurtured and grown. So I want to ask right now, men and women, this is no shock, communicate differently. We network differently. I'm just wondering, could you please just let me know if you're male or female in the chat box so I can gauge how much to focus on networking for women versus networking for both genders. So just, if you would, please hit me up with a male or female, M or B. I'm sorry, M or F, male or female. Right now we have gender-free. I'll wait a moment so you can let me know what you are. What I did come to realize, I'll move on, was that women especially could use some help in the way that we network. And I also found for myself the things that I need to pay attention to. So this is from HuffPost blog. Women in general tend to have smaller networks of deeper relationships, choosing only to have people in their network who share their value system, as compared to men who see their network as a way to get ahead, so are less concerned with a shared value system and more interested in what the relationship can yield. So I thought that was right there. I said, bingo. That explained a lot. And it goes on to say, more women are joining professional women's organizations because they want to have meaningful relationships with other women who will support them in their work. For myself, the entire goal of networking in 2017 is to bridge the gap between online and real time, so that you can end up having a fluid sort of relationship in both where it's possible. Sometimes you can meet a person at a live event, and then the next day, what I would do is I would look them up online, probably on LinkedIn, but then the opposite can happen and you get to know someone online and then eventually meet live. But there's no doubt that the combination is the way we need to be playing the game today. So networking gives us a chance to mix it up. When should you network? And I will tell you this, whenever you can, whether you're employed by someone else or you're self-employed or you're thinking of going off on your own, networking events should really be worked into your schedule on a regular basis. Now, the beauty of that is that it's up to each person's discretion on what you want to attend, what you want to focus on, what the options are, so that you have control over the most judicious use of what are really our most precious resources these days, being our money, our energy, and our time. So that is why I call it strategic networking. We're not really doing it for our health. We're doing it for our wealth. Growth means the personal growth that comes from when you put yourself out there in the world and you're having the integrity to show up, to see and be seen, and also to learn from other people. So you're connecting with people whom then you can go on to do business with and repeated business with. And that is a very nice way to go through your life and your career. It brings balance and abundance to individuals and then to their families and that to the communities. And that's what it's all about. And now the most important piece of this is having fun. So I wouldn't be in this if I didn't enjoy many of the things that I attend. And I'm often lately much older than other people at the event. I went to a bowling night. I was easily 25 years older than the next younger person. But who cares? I've had networking dinners, cocktail parties, breakfasts, lunch, outdoor jazz festival, and one college basketball game where I just had a blast. And I have gone on to meet people who've become clients as well as friends. So it's definitely a viable way to play the game, and it is a game. And for me, it's all under the umbrella of good communication skills. And at the root of good communication skills are breathing. I want you to have a look at the screen, to have a look at this image, and then start to notice your breathing, because that's really at the root of it all. Mentally, perhaps place yourself in this picture. And when we tend to get stressed, perhaps nervous going into a networking event, we tend to hold our breath. And the deeper breathing allows us to gain control of the rest of the body. It really has to follow after if you're having nice, slow, diaphragmatic breaths. And that in turn lets us focus and become calmer and lets us be more present when we are having conversations with people. There's some people who don't recall a single conversation that they've had at events. You need to be present, otherwise, why bother? I love this quote by Sonia Sotomayor. I'm going to read it. I know that some of you might not be able to see it, but it's so good. Sometimes idealistic people are put off the whole business of networking as something tainted by flattery and the pursuit of selfish advantage. But virtue in obscurity is rewarded only in heaven. To succeed in this world, you have to be known to people. And certainly, we'll go here. She is, she had to go, you know, she had to go to a lot of networking events to end up being the first Latina woman to have a place on the Supreme Court. She had to put herself out there. Here she's giving Abby career advice. Okay. Thank you, Maggie, by the way, for forwarding my slides. You're doing a great job. Okay. There is one major misconception that people have about networking. And that was something that Gabrielle Humlucker said. She works for Stacy. She said that she noticed that people tended to go into an event with this assumption that they were going to instantly meet a client or two. And I have to say, I see that expectation far too often. This is not what networking is for. It is not to go in and instantly have a client. Maybe twice that has happened for me, but it's the exception rather than the rule. This is a marathon. It's not a sprint. So something to bear in mind, do not go in with this idea that you are going to score the best gig or the best client of your career in any given event. It's about building relationships. So I want to ask you, here's a networking dinner in Miami for realtors. I want to ask you, networking, the word itself, I think has a bit of a bad rap. And I want to just address this straight on and ask you to please put into the chat box, what comes up for you when you hear the word networking or see an image of it? Just what is your visceral gut response? Be very interested in seeing what how that comes across the plate at you. You can enter it in the chat. I'm not always sure how and where to enter, but here it's the lower right box screen that you can enter. What comes up when I say the word networking? It's probably similar to stuff that comes up when I say the word public speaking, would be my guess.
Katie, are you seeing the chat or do you need me to read them to you?
I'm not seeing, no, I'm glad. I was thinking, gee, nothing's coming up. Go ahead.
I'm seeing meeting people, fake, guys in suits, shaking like a kitty cat, stress, where to start in a room that big.
Good. So these are, thank you for your candor. It's pretty much what you would often easily assume, that where do I even begin? So I'm going to get down to the, here I put a chapter in my book, which is right here. But if I were writing this chapter today, I would make it longer and I would make it much more detailed, because again, it's having a sense of confidence no matter where you are, who's there, what's going on. It's like being just self-possessed, being poised, and being present. So here's, this is the how it often can feel. This is exactly what you might dread. And for those of you, look at your screen, this is the sinking feeling that we might often get. We're feeling, you know, just out of it. So these are things that you can do. First of all, have a game plan. Even if you have to come up with something on the fly, on the way in, that could be something, you know, I'm going to speak to five people who all have red jackets on. I'm just making this up, obviously, but I will stay for 1 hour and then I'm leaving. I will stay until I have five good cards that I have collected from anything. The idea is make it a game and make it fun for yourself. Because if you're not having fun, that's going to be communicated. I do not advise going to a networking event if you're just feeling miserable. Okay, the next thing you can do before you go is, look on the next slide now, Maggie, look at the details, see what you can figure out. Venues are key. There are some places that I no longer go to in the city because they're just too noisy. And if I can't hear, I hate to have to yell, then there's no point in my going. Okay, next slide. The other thing that you can do, take along a couple of friends. Now I'm just going to start, like when I'm RSVPing, I'm just going to automatically say for two. And then I can take a friend, I can take my husband if he's interested. Okay, back to the subject of husband and men. Next slide. I'm going to read this. It came out a little small, but it says, she is saying to this man, I take it this means the barbecue is ready. We obviously behave very differently when we network. And I think that as women, we really have to go to the next slide. I need to tell you what Ben Franklin himself said. Hide not your talents, they for use were made. What's a sundial in the shade? So this gives us permission from Ben Franklin to shine forth and really allow you to be your best. Next slide. What's coming across in when you're communicating is not so much what you're saying, it's how you're saying it. So this graph, chart, pie chart says your physiology, which is how you seem, how you stand, how you move, is sending 55% of the message. Your tonality, which is how you sound, 38%, which leaves only 7% for the actual verbal content. So in my book, that means I have to be very certain about what it is, what the messages are that I want to get out. Okay, next slide, please, Maggie. Okay, you definitely want to take this seriously. This is not another day at the office when you're presenting or when you're presencing yourself, and networking is presencing. You want to, it's showtime. It's not another day at the office. So next, this is red is a power color. Always also get your stuff out before so you can make sure it is clean, crisp, it still fits you. This is my cat, of course, walked right over it, but I figured out what I needed to do. With the power color, next slide, this is a client of mine who is in finance on Wall Street. So male-dominated industry. She does not do formal presentations. She does sort of quick pitches about her stock picks. What she was feeling was not comfortable going into these various male-dominated events and then networking after. She felt sort of like she was a fraud, like she didn't really belong with the group. So we looked at her wardrobe choices. She's absolutely gorgeous, by the way. She got these shoes, which were expensive. They empower her, but they let her do a whole 180 on her confidence, on being able to, you know, banter with the boys. She found, and it's not just the shoes alone, and this is like our third month working together. However, I wanted to say she's working on feeling like she belongs, like she's a contender. So yesterday I got this update from her. Thank God for all the work I've been doing. I spoke with my friend. I've been recommended to be on a board. This is something that as part of her career, she is strategically trying to get on a board. Not only that, but the other management team I've been targeting to hire me requested a meeting with me, to pray for me. So when you begin to vibrate at an appropriate wavelength for who you are and what you are about, then other people pick up on it. And in her case, she's enjoying quite a ride. And it's just because we're looking at every aspect of how she's communicating. Okay, next slide. This is somebody who works in a very upscale museum. So she's dealing with all sorts of people, wealthy donors, staff, all sorts of the public. We're working for her on working on her her confidence, her assertiveness, but also having fun. So she picked these out. I love them. And they are having that effect on her when she wears them. Okay, next slide. Do not go up to people and start giving them your elevator pitch. This happens way too often. It's a big no-no. Don't conflate marketing with networking. Networking, next slide, is you make small talk. You're not giving your elevator pitch unless you're at an event where you go around the room one by one and give your pitch. That's fine, but don't walk up to a group of people who are talking about their kids and start rattling off your pitch. Next, name tags lately are an issue. I see all sorts of poor women getting them stuck in their hair, on their clothing. I'm thinking of having a nice pin made of my logo, so it's something permanent and pretty. And then you put it on the upper right shoulder so that when you extend your hand to shake it, you can easily look at the name of the person whose hand you're shaking. I'm always giving these furtive glances at people's name tags. Also, watch what you call yourself. I had written coach at one event, and they thought that that meant that I worked for coach. So these things matter. Okay, next slide. Do not look around you to see who else is in the room. This is very rude. Don't do it. And if somebody's doing it to you, feel free to turn and leave. That is extremely irritating. Next slide. Okay, you've got options here. Let me get into them. First, the breakfast. Next slide. Breakfast meetings are good if you're a morning person. This is from a real breakfast. Sarah Bean Ricca at Morgan Stanley has lovely breakfasts. Make sure you bring your business cards with you because your cards are offering as you're acting as your props. Next slide. The thing about these is you have to love them. And I really mean love. Next slide, please. This is mine. I love the logo. I love the card. They're nice and sturdy. The card holder should also be something that you love. So red power color. Don't keep them in your wallet. A dog-eared business card, I'm sorry, it does send a certain message. Next slide, please. Networking groups. There are many in New York City and there are many in other places. One woman who is an introvert, next slide, is Dory Clark. She writes for Harvard Business Review. Next slide. So she writes that she doesn't like networking. So she created, she has her own, she'll invite different people to one of her favorite restaurants. Oops. Favorite restaurants in Manhattan is Rosa Mexicana. So she invited, I was present at one dinner, maybe 12 people. And it was very nice. And of course, I worried about not being interesting enough. There's always something to worry about, but you want to have the fun in it. Next slide, of course, Allied Professional Women by Stacey Francis. There's BNI, Mixed Gender, NABO, Females Over 40. And then Dory's opposite is an extrovert. And my dear friend, next slide, Jenny Powers. Her group is called Running With Heels, and she calls it networking for women who hate networking. Her quote, which I really loved, networking is not about closing the sale, it's about opening the relationship. So with that in mind, back to my client with the red shoes, next slide. She's an athlete and she's a very good golfer. So being in a male-dominated field, I've been begging her to invite some of her male colleagues to play tennis. Next slide. My alma mater, Carnegie Mellon, had an NYU basketball game. I went to that. I had so much fun. I don't understand a thing about basketball. But afterwards, we went, we had pizza, we hung out, we schmingled and bingled. It was a lot of fun. Next. Okay, this is horrible. And I've had people do it to me. I've learned to shake them off. But these people who will just attach themselves to you and cling to you like glue, you do not want to let them hang on you. They will suck everything out of you. You just say things like, you don't apologize for leaving. You say, thank you for the chat, or good to meet you. I need to mingle a bit, or going for some air. It doesn't matter what, you just get out of there. Now, next slide. The thing that you want to bear in mind is, you want to go in feeling like you are a glowworm. And I definitely feel that when it's showtime, when you're networking, it's time to be a glowworm. It's not the time, as Franklin said, to hide your light under the shade. Next slide. Do not monopolize the conversation. I have a horrifying story of what happened to me once in a small group of four, but we don't have time. Email me later if you'd like to hear it. Okay, next slide. Paula Rizzo wrote this book, which I love, and she just presented last week at an event that Jenny Powers produced on how to get media attention. She said, somebody asked about thank you cards. She said in 17 years of working at Fox News, she's received on two hands, she can count how many thank you cards she's received. So guess who sent her a thank you card? Next slide. This is what I sent. It's another layer that you can express who you are. So for me, this means cats and champagne and cake on the terrace, but it can be anything. It's another way of deepening the bond. Okay. The follow-up, this is not follow-up. This is actually prep. If you feel anxiety, do a little meditation. The other thing that you can do to prep, I'm sorry, next slide. That's meditation. And then I also, next slide, like working with these, the homeopathic for like stage fright or social anxiety, Bach Rescue Remedy Gum. They also have, next slide, these tinctures, put them under your tongue. Even if they are placebos, they work, So, okay, next slide. Still one of the best things you can do is call people. I know that there are different feelings about different generations have about the phone. Next slide. I grew up talking on it. This is not me, but it could be. But younger generations, I believe, need to embrace the idea of picking up the phone. Next slide, please. I decided, this is Nigel. Nigel's mother is somebody that I started networking with, emailing her back and forth. She works at my alma mater, Carnegie Mellon. She then asked me, as we developed this relationship, if I would give a speech, and here it is, very unflattering, but this is a plenary speech that I gave. And after that, someone in the audience, and this was 3 years ago, said, oh, Katie recommended me to lead a retreat next week on mindful communications. If you're on the call now, a shout out to Mount Lebanon Department of Education administrators. I can't wait to see you next week in Pittsburgh. Okay, next slide, please. Again, if I had to do again today, I would write a longer chapter on networking. And next slide, if you go to my website and sign up for my newsletter, which I'm not abusive with, I'm very sparing with it, you'll get my 10 best tips on creating self-confidence. Now, I want to leave you with this. It's an African proverb, and it says, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go with others. So with that, I want you all to go out into the world, my dear little glowworms, shine on. I am here if you need me. And if you have any questions, I'd be very happy to answer them in the few moments that we have left.
Thanks, Katie. That was great. I'll remind everyone, if you have a question, you can use the chat box or you can email info@savvyladies.org. And we had some questions come in, and the first one here is a comment. So Katie, maybe you have some things you want to share. It's, one of the things that I realized does not work for me is happy hour networking. It's loud and it's difficult to make connections in that setting. I prefer breakfast networkings because usually you are sitting down and everyone is able to say who they are and what they do. Do you want to just share a little on that?
I think that's perfect. I agree. I don't like, if, again, I have a list of venues in Manhattan that I won't go to because it's not worth it because the audio is so bad. The sound is so bad. Definitely, it pays to know your type. Dory Clark does not do breakfasts because she's not a morning person. So it really, you need to be, again, savvy about picking which events are going to be the best fit for you. Good note.
Okay, thanks. A question for you is, when you mentioned bringing a wing woman, do you ever find that it holds people back from connecting with new people? Walking into a room with someone else would definitely put me much more at ease, but I know I'd end up sticking with her the whole time.
That's sweet. The reason is not to just have company, but to invite somebody who will encourage you to extend yourself and engage. So you would make that clear in advance. Listen, I'm asking you to this because my tendency is to sort of withdraw, but I really need to extend myself and definitely ask someone who is perhaps more outgoing than you are. That makes it easier. I've done that with various friends of mine. It's like, I don't have a problem going up to somebody and introducing my friend on her behalf, you know, so. But if it makes you feel more comfortable, that's what you want to attend to. Because when you're more comfortable, you're more your natural self. And then people get a much better sense of who you are and where you're coming from.
Okay, great. Thanks. Another question is, do you have some tips on how to initiate conversations with people? I'm intimidated to approach a group, but I would like help talking to someone standing on her own or maybe a group of just two or three women.
I'm so happy that question was just asked. I'm reaching for my book right now for that chapter because the whole point of it is that you don't have to, it's not really what you say, it's just getting the ball rolling. So where is it? What I like to do, I always say things like, well, it's true that women dress for other women. So when I go to events, I make sure to wear something interesting, like usually a piece of jewelry. And then what the things that I will say to other people are things like, where did you get that? Do you know anyone else here? Where's the bar? Do you work near here? I love your jacket. I mean, there are just so many things to get the conversational ball rolling that it's really not the exact words more than just the intention of, you know, and certainly giving a compliment on something that you really like is easy. Well, it's very easy for me. So again, women dress for other women, so you might bear that in mind.
Okay. And I think this might be the last question, or we might have another one, but it's, how do I know if I'm being a barnacle to someone else?
Well, that would be when you notice that you're not really there to experience other people, that when you notice that you might be clinging to one person only, you have to become aware of it before you can do anything about it. But usually the idea for these events is that you don't want to get caught or stuck in any one pairing or group. You want to have be nimble and be able to move around. In a way, it's a numbers game. So the more people that you're able to connect with in a real comfortable way, the better your odds are of finding somebody that you will end up doing business with. So it's, again, self-awareness.
Okay. All right. We did have another question come in. It's, I have networked in my company's women's group. I was offered to be introduced to a VP in an organization that I want to get my foot in the door. How can I approach this? I'm intimidated.
Mm-hmm. So you want to start connecting with a VP in an organization, and what are the options that you have available to you given the fact that you're intimidated? So what you would want to look at is the intimidation is it's a fear response, and it comes when we put too much emphasis on where it should not be. Where your emphasis needs to be now is on what you bring to the party, not on the seniority of the people or the scale of the party, but bring it down very real and organically to what you know you contribute. And then you might begin by following this person on social media. I have found that definitely people notice when you, and not just liking things, but take the time to give a comment. You can begin with that. You could send them a card. I mean, really, these are very simple but extremely effective ways in to get people's attention and to separate yourself out. You might look on LinkedIn to see if you have any mutual connections with this person or within the organization. That's always a very good conversation starter. So look to see, you know, where would you be most comfortable initiating, but understand that the overall goal is that you extend your comfort zone out and out and out and grow the confidence by believing in yourself and preparing effectively for these various events. If you're not well prepared, you could be setting yourself up to be, to have an uncomfortable or embarrassing episode. You just want to be prepared.
Okay. All right. Well, those are the questions we have for now. So I want to thank you, Katie, for an excellent presentation. And thanks to everyone who joined us and had comments and questions. They were really great. We hope you'll be joining us again. And we will be sending out Katie's information here if you want to connect with her in the future. Thanks again so much, Katie.
You bet, Maggie. Thank you, everybody. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Now sign on.
Bye-bye.
Bye.